the picture is so unusual because it's almost like a textbook type of collision. And the powerboat sitting on top of the sailboat, it looked a little bit staged.
Once we saw the photo, the first thing is we wanted to learn exactly what happened. And then we shared it with our readers on our social media, and it quickly became the most viewed thing that we posted that year.
So when the accident happened, I was actually teaching a captain's license course, and I was teaching rules of the road. So I saw the picture at the end of the day when I came out of the classroom, and I was really relieved to hear that there were no injuries, and that was just really lucky. So we went out on the water and went about trying to recreate this accident. So your immediate gut reaction as a professional mariner and teaching collision avoidance, I can totally see how this happens because of something called constant bearing decreasing range.
We started to kind of plot it out where we put in the latitude longitudes into our chart plotters. We started to get it on the maneuvering board. We kind of broke down what happened, and you can use anything on the boat, a stanchion, you know, something on the boat that's fixed, and line it up on that on a vessel you're not sure about. And as long as that vessel's moving left or right of that fixed point in your boat, it should pass ahead of you or behind you. But if it stays right in line with that object on the boat, that stanchion, then and it gets closer, you're on a collision course.
We could see how this happened very clearly. So from the powerboat operator's perspective, what he would have seen was a sailboat off of his port bow. He would have seen a sailboat there, and probably from when it was way off in the distance, and it would have not moved from that place while they were approaching one another for some time. And after looking at the accident report, we see it was several minutes that they were approaching one another.
And here's where it gets kind of cloudy, because I was brought up as a sailor, but became all things boater, right? So I have lots of powerboats and lots of sailboats. Sailboaters are taught, if you're sailing and you're in a small vessel, then you have right of way over powered vessels, meaning that they have to keep clear of you. As long as you don't turn into them, they have to keep clear of you. Except you have to do what you can to avoid a collision. So it doesn't make any difference if you're sailing. You have to avoid collision. He's supposed to stay out of your way. At the point that you realize that this boat to your right is not staying out of your way, you have to turn to avoid.
We can see it in the report that the sailboat operator gave, and there's quotes that I think that were in the newspaper saying, I saw the other boat and I knew I had the right of way. And technically that's not correct. We have stand on vessels and give way vessels. A stand on vessel initially is directed to maintain course and speed. The giveaway vessel, it's very straightforward. The giveaway vessel is supposed to get out of the way of the other boat. In this case, the powerboat was the giveaway vessel. He's supposed to get out of the way and do it early. The stand-on vessel goes through a series of things that they're supposed to do. Initially, maintain course and speed. But then the rule is very interesting because it says, when it becomes apparent that the other vessel, the giveaway vessel, is not taking appropriate action, the stand-on vessel may take action to avoid a collision. So you're allowed, saying that you're released from your obligation to maintain course and speed, and now you may take action when you see that the giveaway vessel is not taking appropriate action. And then in the final stage of this, the stand-on vessel is directed in its shall take action when action by the giveaway vessel alone is not going to be sufficient to avoid a collision. So you go through this three-step process on the stand-on vessel side.
To be safe, you need to be aware, constantly be on alert, and move out of the way if you have to, even if you're the stand-on vessel.
So with regard to the powerboat, and we're kind of stuck on Rule 5. Captain Matt, who's out there on the powerboat during the reenactment, says you can't, it's just screaming Rule 5, which is lookout. It's a one sentence long rule, but it says a ton. It says we're supposed to look out by sight and hearing and all available means at all times. You want to be very vigilant, but you've got to avoid complacency, and you really want to be on the edge of your seat all the time out there, making sure that you see everything that's around you, making sure you're maintaining what we call situational awareness. So neither captain went out on the water that day thinking that they were going to have an accident. And it, you know, pardon the pun, but it just wasn't on their radar screen. The thing is, we get so used to situations that we can have to guard against becoming complacent. Like, they always avoid me. That you know, they always swerve at the last minute. Doesn't mean that we don't take proper precautions, like sounding your whistle or trying to alert the other boat or second guessing. Does he really see me?
Whether you're a commercial fisherman, whether you're a recreational sailboater, whether you're a recreational powerboater, whichever, we all have to follow the rules of the road. Everyone's responsible. And so it's important that everyone know those rules because we can clearly see here that there's 3, 4, or 5 rules that were broken here and led to a collision.
So opinions and passions run deep when it comes to this particular collision. And sailors feel one way about it and powerboaters feel another way about it. But we're not here to address those opinions. We went out and recreated this accident on the water. We're here to try to talk about how do we avoid these things in the future.
Powerboaters and sailors are two distinctly different groups of people. They're different in almost every way. However, one of the things they love the most is being out on the water. So just realize that that person in that other boat doesn't think like you do, right or wrong. They might not be out there doing the same things that you're doing. So just respect them, that they're having fun in the same environment you are, and make sure you're constantly being alert to what's going on, to every situation, and how you're gonna get out of it.
So both boats could have taken actions to avoid this collision. In the case of the powerboat, it seems that he did not see the sailboat. When it comes to the sailboat, he sees the powerboat coming, but gets stuck on maintaining course and speed and doesn't progress through the obligations of the stand-on vessel as he is eventually required to take action to avoid a collision. So the rules of the road are there to keep us safe and give us a set of guidelines and rules to follow so that we avoid colliding with one another. But a lot of it is common sense. You just have to try to use, you keep your heads up, you keep your head on a swivel, and then you make decisions and you take action to avoid a collision. In fact, that's even one of the rules.